The typically what I have patients do is it's very tender in the first month or so to fully stretch out the calf. In other words, fully put your foot flat on the floor. So what I ask patients to do is to go out and buy a very thick heeled shoe. Like they have these, you see them at Walmart or Target. They're very thick foam rubber sandals that may have just a high wedge back. And so they get a 3-inch pair, a 2-inch pair, 1-inch, and then they can go back to their regular shoes. We start off with the patients getting up out of bed and just wearing those 3-inch heels, or 3-inch wedges, so that they're not really making their foot very flat at all. And it's tender to walk around, but they're able to manage their day. And then after a week, they can go to the 2-inch, and then a subsequent week, they'll go to the 1-inch and then flat. So they're gradually stretching out the calf and the calf muscle, and as the implant is incorporated and falls into place. I want people to be up and walking and moving around after the surgery, mainly because of the risk of blood clots or blood clots that develop in the veins around the area of surgery. And if you really lay still for an extended period, that's a bit of a higher risk. So I want people to move around, but you have to just walk around gingerly.